Welcome to another video. Today, we will be performing a multi-timeframe analysis and checking the order flow for a specific pair to understand how we can be looking for potential profitable opportunities on the specific pair that we are analyzing. This is very educational because you will understand which are the key concepts that you're supposed to be applying in your trading. And it will also be practical because you will be understanding which is the best zone to be looking for a potential trading opportunity on the specific pair that we are analyzing. Now, if you're new to the channel, I'm a top author on the TradingVIEW platform and I share free education and analysis on all my platforms daily. So I suggest you subscribe and I will see you in the video. Okay, so let's make a full breakdown of GBPJPY, which is a very interesting pair to follow at the moment for a potential trading opportunity. So make sure you stick to the end of the video because I will show you exactly how we can be looking for a potential trading opportunity. And during the analysis, I will be giving out as much free education as I can. So let's start our top-down analysis. From a technical perspective, then we will check the order flow and we will see where we can be looking for a potential trading opportunity. So let's start by the monthly time frame. Now on the monthly time frame, what do we have? On the monthly, we can see that clearly the market has been rejecting this very strong level of support. It rejected the first time here. Again, the market respected the zone here, preceding all this huge move to the upside. And again, lately the market has tested its zone and rejected it to the upside. Now, if we check at what we have from a candlestick pattern formation perspective, what we can see is that the last candle that we have here is the candle that we expect the next one to try at least to fill in the wick. So we can expect some short-term bullishness in the GBPJPY, at least from a monthly perspective. Let's go down on the weekly and see what kind of situation we have from a weekly perspective. Now going down on the weekly time frame, there is one thing that appears immediately clear. Just a quick reminder, make sure you comment below and you let me know which pair or topic you would like me to cover or analyze in the next video. On the weekly time frame, in fact, what we can see is that the market is approaching a very strong level of structure resistance, which was a historical structure level for this market, acting as very strong support here. Broke to the downside, turn resistance, broke back up, turn support, then the market broke it to the downside, turn resistance, fake breakout to the upside, break back below. And this level is now acting as resistance, and it seems like the market is now going to test this strong structure resistance. So on the weekly time frame, it appears immediately clear that this is definitely a level that the market is supposed to test and reject to the downside, at least from a short-term perspective, meaning that at least we want to see a reaction to the area. Let's go on the daily time frame and see what kind of situation we have from a daily perspective. On the daily time frame, what we can see? We can see that clearly the market has created this W formation and is creating this W formation. And this is the level that we have just identified on the weekly time frame. So what does it mean? It means that the weekly resistance that we have identified is going to be tested, at least that is what it seems at the moment, is going to be tested with the creation of a W formation. So the completion zone of the W formation is the resistance. And what do you expect after you have a W formation in general? You expect the market to make a move to the downside and go and test the neckline. So complete the pattern at the previous resistance, which is now turned support. So the fact that this completion zone is also the weekly resistance is definitely an added confluence, very strong added confluence for the completion of the pattern to the downside. So very good to have identified this. Now, before I show you how we will be approaching this kind of situation with students, let's go and see what we have from a COT perspective on the GBP and what we have from a COT perspective on the JPY. Okay, so if we check what we have from a COT perspective, so commitment of traders, what big banks and institutions are currently doing in the market from a GBP perspective. We can see that if we look at the long term, we went from 35k net positions all the way down to minus 36k net positions, which means that hedge funds went from having more longs than shorts, so 76k longs and 40k shorts, all the way down to having 63k shorts and 26k longs, so more shorts than longs, the completely opposite situation. And in fact, we have seen a strong decrease in the strength of the pound across all pairs. And if we check what we have in the short term, so what happened in the last weeks, we can see an increase in the net positions with longs getting added, thousands of longs getting added, and a huge amount of shorts getting closed. 10k shorts closed here, another 7k shorts closed here. In fact, net positions clearly increasing. In fact, the strength of the pound lately has been increasing. But if we go and see what we have from a JPY perspective, we can see that in the long term, clearly we had a huge shift to the positive side, going all the way up at 34k net positions, then down to 22, and now again increasing to 27. So overall, JPY has been getting stronger, and now again, it is again becoming stronger with 7k longs added with the last report, and also a little bit of shorts, but overall net positions clearly increasing. So overall, we can expect some short-term JPY strength, which gives us the possibility to complete the pattern, given also the GBP that can in the long term still have weakness. So how we will be approaching this kind of situation, now that we know that also from a COT perspective, we are kind of aligned. We don't have anything against our analysis. What we can do and how we will be approaching this with students. We know that inside of this area, this is the completion zone of the W formation. And we also know that at the moment, the market is very bullish from a 4-hour perspective. Now, why am I checking the 4-hour time frame? Because always remember, monthly, weekly, and daily are for direction. The 4 hours is the best time frame when it comes to entry. And if the 4-hour time frame will remain bullish as it is right now, obviously we can't be looking for any short. We will, as usual, have to be reactive and not predictive. Trading is reactive, not predictive. So the way in which we will be approaching this with students is very simple. We will be monitoring price action from a 4-hour perspective inside of this area, waiting for the market to provide to us one of our valid entries after shifting from a bullish market to a bearish market. So if the market inside of this area will shift from a bullish market to a bearish market, then we will add this pair on watchlist. And as soon as the market will provide to us one of our valid entries, we will be taking a nice short with a very good risk to reward and very good probabilities for the market to make the move to the downside and complete the pattern at the previous resistance here, now turned support. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you smash that like button and comment below. It really does support the creation of more free education and analysis for all of you. Also, make sure you go and check out the mentorship program. You find the link in the description. It's a very complete program. You first learn all the rules of my rule-based strategies, and then you trade them with me each and every day. In fact, I give you the market breakdown showing you exactly how to apply the strategies with entry, stop, take profit, as well as answering every single question that you have every day. So it's a very complete program. I suggest you go and check it out. Link is in the description, or I will see you in the next video.